Hi, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day. Today I want to show you how you can use Adobe Express for free to edit your PDFs. You will need to create a free account to do this with Adobe Express. I'll put the link down below in the description. And then once you're here, you can go ahead and just go get signed up and go through those few steps. And once you get your account, then we'll go from there. I'm all logged in to my Adobe Express free account here, and you're going to notice if you haven't logged in before, this can do a lot more than just edit your PDFs. Take a look at this. You can create and edit videos inside this Adobe Express free account. I have a different video on that that I'll put a link to in the card up above and in this description down below. And if I keep scrolling down here, notice the AI tools that are built in. If I wanted to go text to image or generative fill, these things are a ton of fun to play around with. But we're here to edit our PDFs. So what I want to do is go to the quick suggested quick actions. We can get to the quick actions a couple different ways. Also on this plus here, if I click it, there's the quick actions and I can kind of scroll through and notice there's edit PDFs here. If you want to go to this view, view all, and if I scroll down, we have edit PDF here. So I'm just going to go ahead and click this. And I'm gonna go ahead and upload, and I can just drag in. So I have some PDFs on the side over here. I'm gonna just take this and drag it in. So that only took a few seconds to upload it and turn it into something I can edit. If I scroll down, you can see I have a chart, we have a table, and we even have some image. And you can edit all of these inside Adobe Express. So just some quick examples, because you're going to see how to do this on your own. But anything that I highlight here, I can go ahead and make any changes if it's from the type of font it is, to the color, to all these different things that I can quickly change. And if you don't like what you do, you can always undo up top. You can go back those steps. The other thing that you can do, if I scroll down, this graph is an image. It's broken down into individual pieces too. So I could go ahead and delete out of here. And remember, you have the undo. I can go through and edit any of these tables. I can move around the text in here if I didn't want it. I can delete it out. At any time, I can insert new text. Notice down here, I can add text or images. So if I was going to go and just add new text anywhere on the page, I can create a text box and write in it. And I can set the format to what I want, move it around. Whenever I have the text selected, I get different options to change, delete, cut, copy inside of here. And also image. If we want to add an image, we can go and grab it, and it's going to upload and put the image right into that PDF, and we can go ahead and start editing on here. So I'm just going to go ahead on this one. If I right click, hit delete, it's gone. So very easy to manipulate. Even on any of these pictures inside here, I could go to it, start editing the PDF here. I could go and notice if I have this selected, I can replace the image from here. So you can make all those quick edits to whether it be the text, images, different things like that, or add your own. We can even work with comments here. And if we look on the right-hand side, we do have comments over here where I can add comments. I could edit the comments, lots of options. If you want a different view, just select the different view and you can go to the different pages real quickly. And also you can go through the pages here and you can go through and zoom in and zoom out. Also take advantage of the tools for marking up. So if I wanted to highlight anything, I can just go through, highlight, notice how I can change colors if I want. I can even draw on this with how I want to bring any attention, and that gets all put into the download when I save it. So when you're all done, you can just go ahead and download it and it's going to put it back as a PDF. I do want to point out, depending on how much you need to be using it, you're allowed 10 quick actions per month for the PDF. So if it's something you are using daily, maybe this won't be the right choice for you. But if it's something you only need a couple times a month to edit some PDFs, this is a great option. I want to show you how you can, here's another way you could reorder pages of your PDFs or even combine PDFs. Now for this next one, we're going to just go this way to the quick actions right here. And we're going to go down to the very bottom and it's going to be organize pages. Make sure after I do this one, I am going to be talking about converting from PDF and converting to PDF as well. But right now, organize pages. And I'm going to go ahead and drop that same file that I had in here. So I drag and drop it over. And at this point, so this is a multi-page PDF, and when it uploads, I can just click on a page and drag it around. Now I have my 5-page PDF document. Let's say I don't want it to be in this order. Notice I can just click and drag and move the pages around. So it makes it very easy to do that, to manipulate all the different pages the way you want. I can add another file here, so I can click or upload, or I'll drag again. I'll drag just this one pager, and this will upload it, and I can combine two different PDFs here if I wanted to have it. So now I have this extra page, and I can place it where I want. And then when I'm all done, I can go ahead and download this as a PDF. So back to quick actions again. And I just want to point out at the bottom, I did organize pages. You could combine files this way too, if it was just about combining files. I just tend to go to the organize page. But let's take a look at converting. So we can convert from PDF into PDF. So if I go and convert from PDF, this is going to upload a PDF and it's going to convert it to Microsoft Word or Excel or PowerPoint. All I need to do is take it, drag it over, and then with the drop down, I can pick what do I want to be. Do I want it to be just an image or a Word document? And then when you choose it, just go ahead and hit download and it converts it over with that extension. Now that it's downloaded, if I take a look, here it is as a Word file that I could go ahead, open it up in Microsoft Word now. If you need to convert something into a PDF, just go to convert to PDF and you're going to notice it. I'll just go down a little bit, convert to PDF, drag over. In this case, I'm going to drag over a PowerPoint. You can choose different formats and then it's just going to go through. And once it's creating my PDF, I can download it as that. So it took my PDF or my PowerPoint and now this is a PDF that I can go through, download it, and I have it. I hope you find this video helpful in editing and transforming your PDFs. Do take a look at all the other things Adobe Express offers in the free account, and I'll just attach my playlist to my other Adobe Express videos up top in the card as well. Have a great day, and I'll see you next time on Teacher's Tech with more tech tips and tutorials.